It is now my pleasure to introduce Mackenzie. The people are going to introduce the shortest but feistiest person on our team, Mackenzie Campbell. And I'm going to turn the podium over to Jordan and Austin Campbell, Corey Streckengross, and the infamous Zoe to introduce your 2011-2012 Nevada State Secretary.
About Mackenzie. She's very driven, she's very determined, and growing up with her, she's been able to tackle everything that she's been put forth, and she's been a great inspiration to me, and I love her to death. She's the greatest sister I could have ever asked for.
Aloha, ¿cómo estás? My name is Jordan. Mackenzie Campbell's little brother. I like to start off with The greatest time I've ever had with my sister is when we were at McCall, Idaho, and we were wakeboarding around 9 o'clock at night. My sister says, "Do a flip." I said, "Nah, I don't think so. Come on, I'll pay you $5. Fine. As I go outside the wake and cut back in to the wake and just flop on my back and get a mouthful of water, I come up to the boat and say, "Does it count?" "Yes, Jordan." So I get $5, right? "Yes, I guess so." Even though I still haven't got that $5, my sister is still one of the best sisters in the world.
Hi guys, my name is Corey Streckengross, and Mackenzie's been my friend for quite a few years, ever since I moved to Nevada. She's an awesome person. She's someone that you can definitely look up to. I've never known her to give up on anything, and she's always given everything her all. Our freshman year, we were on a parley team together, and we walked into our room and we started debating, and everything was going pretty well, and I was the chairman, so I was up at my podium. And so I call Mackenzie's name to begin debate, and in the middle of her debate, my phone starts ringing. And it's ringing pretty loud and inappropriate. And so Mackenzie's just giving her debate, and it's just an example of how she's always, no matter what happens, Mackenzie gives everything her all and never gives up. And I was so happy with her for getting a state office, and she's done such a great job.
Okay, so Mackenzie and I have been roommates this year, and every single day she never stops amazing me. Corey, your phone's ringing.
Hello? Oh, I can't talk about this right now, babe. I'll call you back. Love you.
Okay, so Mackenzie never stops amazing me. Every time somebody gives her a task, she takes it and tackles it with 110% and always puts a smile on her face. Mackenzie is definitely one of those people that I could look up to for anything. She always puts me back in my place when it's needed. She could be a shoulder to cry on, and every time I want to go on a little adventure, she's always there for me. You guys are very lucky to have had her this year, and I'd like to introduce you to your Nevada State Secretary, Mackenzie Campbell.
Lay back on the radio down. Fire got lit inside a bright-eyed child. Every note just wrapped around his soul. Steel guitars from Memphis all the way to rock and roll.
little shorter than I am now, and full of that powerful little girl attitude. One day, on a family trip to Utah, my dad decided he was going to take his little three-year-old skiing for the first time. Now, if any of you have ever attempted to learn how to ski or snowboard, you know how difficult the first time is. When you add in the factors that it was freezing, I was dressed in so many layers, I could hardly move. And I was only 3 years old, you realize how much worse the situation gets. That day, my dad straps my baby skis on my feet and carries me to the lift. I get on, nervous, excited, and unsure what to expect. When we finally reach the top of this little mountain that seemed like Mount Everest to me, my dad helps me off and the journey begins. But before we go, he stops and teaches me the basics. You know, this is pizza, this is French fry, and try not to cross your skis like this. Me, being only 3 years old, did not understand a word that he said, but looked up at him and said, "Dad, I already know how to ski." My dad laughed a little bit, and off we go. For the first 5 feet, I was fine. Then somehow, I turned, and I fell. I got back up and started going again. 5 more feet, and I'm down. But this time, I lost my ski. Cold and upset, I look up at my dad and say, "Dad, I can't do it anymore. I'm done." My dad laughs and looks down at me and says, "Mac, if you're not crashing, you're not trying." Over the years, as I started trying new things, I was constantly reminded of my dad's simple quote. Each one of us will be faced with our own mountains that we have to overcome. Today, I want each of you to remember that if you're not crashing, you're not trying. In a poem entitled "Keep Moving Forward," it tells about the power we have to overcome mountains. When things seem difficult and life uphill, don't look too far.